I love washing wool. Love it. It is instant gratification. So we are going to start by filling up our sink with super hot water. This is the fleece we're going to be washing today. And this water is super hot. I can't even touch it. It's so hot. I'm going to add some Unicorn Power Scour. This is the best wash for washing fleece. It's super concentrated, earth-friendly, biodegradable, septic-safe. It's the best. And I'm going to add to this amount. I think I'm going to be doing about probably 2 to 3 pounds. So that's 2 to 3 tablespoons. The best part about washing wool, my most favorite part, is the way that it smells. Call me crazy, but when you mix raw, clean, local wool with Power Scour, it smells like magical productivity. And here comes the fun part. Now we just get to put fleece in here. And this fleece doesn't have any vegetable matter in it either. It's just greasy. And it smells divine. I wish you were here. I feel like I'm on a cooking show. I wish you were here to smell this. Washing wool has been my favorite part of the fiber journey for years now. Ever since I got started into it, I adore it. I love the smell of it. I love the process of it. Maybe someday I'll own my own mill just so I can do this all day. Okay, so the water is still pretty steamy and it is like chocolate milk in there. See how brown that is? That is all the dirt and grease and oil. Okay, so we're going to let this sit for I would say 10 minutes. And if you were doing a larger batch of wool or in the washing machine where you had a lid that you could cover this to kind of insulate the water, you could let it sit for 25, 30 minutes. But the reason that I don't have my wools soak as long is because all of the heat is evaporating and I do not want the water to get cool and then the grease attach itself back onto the fiber. I want the grease to stay in the water, and the water needs to stay hot in order for the grease to want to be in the water. So we're going to keep this, it's still too hot for me to touch, and that lets me know that we're still good. So as soon as it starts to get cool enough where my hands feel comfortable in it, I know that it's going to be time to drain this water. And then we're going to refill the sink and see. We don't know if it needs 2 washes or not, and I'll show you how to tell. So I'm going to set the timer for 10 minutes. So, I was thinking about this as I was cleaning. Some people might prefer to use like a laundry basket or something with holes, or you may have seen wool put in mesh bags so that you can just kind of take the wool out of your sink. I've done that before, and I think my problem is I overpack it, and I really like to be able to kind of mush my wool around. So what I'm going to do now is I have a drain thing in my sink that I'm just going to pop open so that the water can drain, and I'm going to gently swish the wool this way. So the wool isn't going to go down my drain, just the water is, because the sink thing will still be covering, but it'll just be popped just enough for the water to go in. So I just kind of popped it with my now we're just going to squish this dirty water out. So let's fill it up with hot water. Super, super hot. And what I'm looking for as I'm filling this sink up with hot water is the color of the water that's coming up from the wool. If it's kind of white and cloudy, I'm okay with that. I don't feel the need to rinse that out because I do like to leave a little lanolin in my wools. I just like the way that feels. My least favorite is when wool feels dry and unmoisturized. And yeah, if I, you might not be able to tell from where you are, but since I've got black everywhere, but I can see the water is very clear. So that lets me know, I mean, it's a little milky and cloudy, but it's not brown and dirty. So I know that this does not need to be washed again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drip some fiber rinse throughout this. There we go. Probably about 2 teaspoons. And I'm going to smush that fiber rinse throughout. And what this is going to do is condition the wool and actually soften it. Many of you are probably saying, aren't you nervous about agitating your wool that much? In my experience, I mean, there might be wools that felt with that much agitation, but what I'm doing, I'm not rubbing the wools together. If you were to see inside the sink, I'm just pressing the wools down. So that is not causing felting. It's really the rubbing together and the friction and kind of circular motions that I've noticed cause felting faster. Whereas just kind of a bouncy up and down of getting the water through the fiber, I have never had issues with felting just with some of this. I find that it makes my cleaning more effective. It just kind of gets the product throughout all of the water. But if you're nervous doing that, you could always take all of this wool out, fill your sink with water, then put the fiber rinse in, then put the wool in. But there really are no rules other than always use hotter water than the temperature of your wool and use an excellent soap and hot water and good soap. This is very hot. Can you see the steam coming off of that? This is hot. Since this is clean, it's just like a conditioning rinse. And I'm going to go ahead and pop up little nozzle in my sink to drain this water. And you can always let yours sit for longer. But I wash like little batches like this, I find don't need really, really long times of soaking. It's when you're doing an entire top loading washing machine of wool when you really need that 20 to 30 minutes to get through everything. But when you can kind of press down the water and get it, all the product throughout this fiber. Yeah, and the water is a little bit of a tea brown, but I personally am okay with that because, as I said, I like to leave just a bit of lanolin in my fibers because I like my fibers to feel moist and supple. And I know from experience the lanolin or the grease that's in this type of wool, this Border Lester lamb, is not going, it's never going to be tacky. It's a low lanolin, so that's mostly dirt that's going out. And so when I set this as a yarn, I'll get the rest of that dirt out, so I'm not worried about it.
Mom, you're making dinner?
No, I'm making clean wool. I'm almost done. So this wool is still very, very, very hot. I'm just gonna kind of shake it out and put it out on my deck to dry. And that is how you can wash wool fleece in your sink. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Feel free. Wool fleece is wool from a sheep. And you can wash it in a sink.